In this video, we are going to be dealing with how to share things between or among people in specific ratio. Let's take an example. So we have this question. 50 toys were shared between Angel and Lovett in the ratio 2:3. How many toys did each girl receive? Now let's try to solve this. Now the first thing you want to note is the total number of toys. So we have total toys equals to 50. Does that make sense? Now we're also given the ratio. So Angel ratio Lovett represent 2:3. So Angel 2, Lovett 3. Does this make sense? Now we are asked, how many toys did each girl receive? Now let's try to solve how many toys Angel received. Now to get how many toys Angel received, I'm going to do Angel's ratio all over total ratio times total toys. Does this make sense? So if it's that they are sharing cakes, this will be total cakes. If they are sharing vehicles, this will be total vehicles. Do you understand? Alright, let's try to do this. Now to get Angel's share of the toys will be, Angel's ratio is 2. So we have 2 all over. Total ratio, that will be 2+3. Do you understand? Total toys, 50. Does this make sense? So we are going to be having 2 all over. 2+3 is 5 times 50 over 1. 5 here 1. 5 in 50 is 10. 2 times 10 will give us 20. So if I'll do the remaining by the side here, it means that Angel's share equals to 20 toys. Do you understand? Now let's try to find Lovett's share. So Lovett's share would be equals to Lovett's ratio all over total ratio times total toys. Do you understand? So Lovett's ratio, that will be 3 all over total ratio 2+3, total toys 50. That will give me 3 all over 2+3 is 5 times 50 over 1. 5 here 1, 5 in 50 is 10. So I have 3 times 10. That will be equals to 30 toys. So it means that Angel received 20 toys while Lovett received 30 toys. So I need to make you understand that if the question just asked you, how many toys did Lovett received? Now you don't need to do this. All you need to do is to do Lovett's share of the toys. Do you understand? So your answer will be 3 all over 5 times 50, which will be equals to 30 toys. Does that make sense? Now the next thing I need you to understand is that to prove that your answer is right, if you add Angel's share to Lovett's share, it should give you the total toys. So 20+30, that is 50. So it means that we are correct. Do you understand? Let's take another question. So in this case, we have a sportmaster shared 450 old balls among 3 of his best players in the ratio 3:5:7. How many balls did each player get? Now this should be a question mark. Now let's solve this. So the first thing you want to note is the total number of balls. So total balls is 450. Does this make sense? So let's represent the first player as player 1, second player, player 2, third player, player 3. Their ratios 3:5:7. Do you understand? Now if you want to get the number of balls player 1 will receive, that will be player 1's ratio all over total ratio. Now in this case we are dealing with balls, so it should be times total balls. Do you understand? So let's do this. P1's ratio is 3. Total ratio will be 3+5+7. Do you understand? Then total balls, we have 450. So we'll be having 3 all over. 3 plus 5 is 8. 8 plus 7 is 15. So 15 times 450 all over 1. Does this make sense? So we're having 5 here, 3. 5 in 45 is 9. 5 in 0 is 0. So we have 90. 3 here, 1. 3 here, 1. So it means that player 1 received 90 balls. Now let's write it here. Player 1 received 90 balls. Now let's find how many balls player 2 received. So we have player 2 equals to player 2's ratio all over total ratio times total balls. Player 2 ratio is 5. So we have 5 all over. Total ratio is 3 plus 5 plus 7 times total balls, 450. So we're having 5 all over. 3 plus 5, 8 plus 7 is still 15 times 450 all over 1. Do you understand? 5 here, 3. 5 in 450 is 90. Then we have 3 here, 1. 3 in 90 is 30. 5 times 30, that is 150 balls. So player 2 received 150 balls. Now let's solve for the last one, player 3. So player 3 would be, player 3's ratio all over total ratio times total balls. Now let's solve the remaining by the side. So we'll be having player 3 would be equals to player 3 ratio is 7. So we have 7 all over 3 plus 5 plus 7 times 450. So this would be equals to 7 all over 3 plus 5 plus 7 will give us 15 times 450 all over 1. 5 year 3, 5 year 90, 3 year 1, 3 year 30. So we are left with 7 times 30, which is 210 balls. So player 1 received 90 balls. Player 2 received 150 balls. Player 3 received 210 balls. Now to prove that you are correct, if you add all the number of balls the players received individually, it should give you the total number of balls, which is 450. Let's try it. 210 plus 90 plus 150. 0 will give us 0. 1 plus 9, 10. 10 plus 5, 15. 5 carry 1. 1 plus 2, 3. Plus 1, 4. 450 balls. Now, lastly, I need to note, if you were just asked how many balls will player 2 receive, you don't need to do for player 1. You don't need to do for player 3. All you need to do is for player 2. I hope you understand.